Welcome. You're listening to Outside the Four Walls with Tony Myers, providing you teachings that will bring Christ into your daily life. Christ in us, the expectation of glory. Now, let's hear today's message.
We are continuing on our journey through my book, Unlocking the Mystery of Divine Healing. We are on Chapter 7. And once again, I'm not reading the whole chapter. Grab the book, read the book, have it handy, and be healed. Thank you, Jesus. And throughout this, please send me an email if you learned from this book and you were healed while learning from it. I want to know about it. So God bless you. We're on Chapter 7, Eager Anticipation. We left off talking about hope that is deferred, and I'd like to share some examples of this from my life. When diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease, my response was that the Lord Jesus would heal me, and yet nothing happened. One reason was that while I was believing this to be true, I really had no hope or expectation. My expectation was believing that someday he would heal me, and that is expectation deferred. Another time, in the back of the church, suddenly the thought came to me, saying, "You're healed. Get up and walk." And immediately another thought came that said, "Idiot, you're paralyzed. You can't." Again, this was because I had no expectation. This happened 3 or 4 times, and I subsequently lost all expectation and gave up. After that, I tried to kill myself. However, on July 4th, everything changed in seconds. The vision that I received of Christ gave me new hope / expectation. This was not a conscious thought. It was something that happened in my heart. And it was at this point that I want to encourage you. Remember, this was after 6 years of pure hell, and now I am able to teach from this experience in order for others to receive their miracle. The Lord is faithful to give us what we need. We just have to put forth the effort to recognize it. Don't think that my case was special or that He chose me and just a few others. That isn't the truth at all. He wants us all healed and spreading the gospel and having a correct belief in this area is the start. Healing is already done, and nothing can stop it except not believing that you are healed. This powerful statement in itself creates hope when it is truly taken as an unquestionable fact into your being. Hope is expectation. Hope is not wishful thinking. Romans 8:24, "For we are saved by hope." Expectation. We are saved by expectation. For now, I am only using just a part of this verse for a reason, but we will get to the rest of it at the end of the chapter. Whenever you see the word hope, change it to expectation. This will help you to change how you look at the word hope. Romans 12:12, "Rejoicing in hope." Expectation. You are expecting a pay raise. You are rejoicing in anticipation. You are planning what will happen with an increase in funds. You are expecting to be married. You are planning for a blissful life. You are expecting a child. You are planning to raise a child, and you are rejoicing. When we are expecting good things to happen, we rejoice and plan. That is why hope is a crucial part to receiving our healing. When we are expecting to be healed, we are rejoicing and planning. That is the nature of expectation. There are not enough words to describe the importance of expecting of the Lord. Hope, expectation in the Lord automatically creates a lifting of the spirit. What follows are some scriptures showing a number of things about hope. Psalm 38:15, "For in thee, O Lord, do I hope, expect. Thou wilt hear, O Lord my God." Psalm 33:18, "Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope, expect in his mercy." Psalm 31:24, "Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. All ye that hope, expect in the Lord." Romans 5:5, "And hope, expectation, maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us." Psalm 33:22, "Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, according as we hope, expect in thee." Do you see how this changes the meaning of Scripture and uplifts our spirit? When our expectation is in the Lord, he delivers. Even more so when we know that he has already delivered our divine health to us at the cross. It is always there, always available, and never disappoints. When we truly have this in our heart, then we are rejoicing and planning. Do you believe God heals? Then the answer will be yes. Do you expect to be healed? Then the answer will be yes. And the thousands of Christians that I pray for will all answer the same. Who is your hope in? Oh, my hope, parentheses, wishful thinking, is in the Lord. I hope, parentheses, wishes, that he heals me. Folks, I've been there, done that, got 12 t-shirts. This isn't a put-down to anyone. This is Tony speaking from experience. We have thousands of things that we take as a fact, and many of them are a contradiction. The Lord is my healer. But sometimes, for unknown reasons, he doesn't heal. The Lord is my healer. Why won't he heal me? There's a Christian song out currently that says, "My faith is in you, God. But when you don't part the water, I so need you to, I still have faith in you." That isn't faith. It is a contradiction. There are so many cute little sayings that show where and who our expectation is. But most of the time it isn't in Christ and his finished work. We do truly get what we expect, good or bad, ugly or awesome. We can either be slaves of our physical senses or enslave our physical senses. It comes down to if we walk in the Spirit or by our physical senses. Romans 8:5 through 8. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then, they that are in the flesh cannot please God. Yes, yes, yes. I know that right now your mind is focused on sin, but hopefully not. For the word flesh can be substituted physical senses. Walking in the flesh is more properly defined as walking by our physical senses. And this is a huge factor in determining what we are in expectation for. Using sin as an example, why do we commit a sin? We commit any sin because we are paying attention to our physical senses. We are walking after our physical senses. Why does anyone get tempted to commit adultery? It is by our sight, or our physical senses overwhelming us, and then we give in. Name any sin, and there will be a physical sense that accompanies it. Let's take anger. We hear or see something that we don't like, and we lash out. As believers, we don't walk in the lusts of the physical senses. We are to put our physical senses in subjection to our spirit, because to live by our physical senses is death. This applies both spiritually and physically. If we live by our physical senses, then our choice is to respond in a physical manner. If we are angered at a person, then we respond by yelling, screaming, or worse, with violence. If we are coveting something that we don't have, then we respond in a physical manner by attaining that object at all cost. When walking carnally, we will reach a solution through our physical actions. Focusing on our physical senses requires a solution through our physical senses, and this is not pleasing to God. One could also say sin is a focus on a lust of the senses. Sin is in the lust of the heart. However, actions often follows. The sin is in the lust, not in the action. Be blessed, be healed, and be a blessing.
You've been listening to Outside the Four Walls with Tony Myers. We hope this teaching has touched your life in such a way that will glorify God and increase your expectation on His promises daily. Outside the Four Walls is a listener-supported ministry. To donate to this program or to connect with Tony Myers, visit his website at tonybelieves.com or drop Tony an email at tonyjustbelieves@gmail.com. You can also find Tony on Facebook at Tony Just Believes. As you go out today, be blessed, be healed, and be a blessing.